This episode of DNews is brought to you by Canon PIXMA Pro Professional Inkjet Printers, exactly as you envisioned. Don't you hate it when you see something beautiful and you pull out your camera and you just can't make it look the same? What is wrong here? Is it me or the camera? Hey everybody, thanks for watching DNews today. I'm Trace. When you think of a robotic version of the human eye, or even like a prosthetic eyeball, you probably picture some kind of camera. It makes sense, they both capture images and video, but aside from general comparisons, they are really not the same at all. When you're looking out through your eyeball, it's doing the same things as a camera. It's adjusting the lens, it's focusing, it's trying to make the image look as good as possible. In fact, generally speaking, again, both the eye and the camera have a lot in common. They have adjustable apertures to let in the right amount of light. They have lenses, and both have ways to absorb that light. But from there, comparisons get a little bit fuzzy, which is an eye pun. The reason your photos don't look the same way as your eye sees them is because of the way the two different mechanisms function. The eye is 28 grams of vitreous fluid, muscles, cells, and nerves. Cameras can be formatted and customized to do literally thousands of different types of shoots. When focusing, the lens of the eye uses the ciliary muscle to change its shape. A lens needs to be physically moved by your hands. When it's bright or dim, the pupil uses the sphincter pupillae to adjust the amount of light being let into the eyeball. The camera has something similar, it's the aperture, and that adjusts that amount of light, which is also kind of sphincter-like. According to research conducted in Canada in the late 50s, the f-stop of the human eye may be around 3.2 to 3.5. I read other things that made it all the way down to 2.1. But regardless, cameras have a far wider range of f-stops and ISO sensitivities to pick up that dim light. When a full-frame camera absorbs light, it does so with a 35mm sensor, compared to the eyeball, which has the retina at the back, and the wall of those cells is curved. But it's almost the exact same size as a camera, at about 32mm. The difference is, the retina isn't very clear. We can only see 20/20 at the macula, or fovea, a spot on the retina that is all cone cells. Outside of the fovea are a mix of rods and cones, followed by just rods out at the edge. This is why you can't read something that you're not looking directly at, and why peripheral vision is mainly just for movement. Additionally, your eye only sees color where there are lots of cones, so closer to the fovea equals more color. A camera, by contrast, can pick up detail across the whole sensor, all in color, no problem. However, even though cameras can see a wider field, the amount of information on that field is relatively low. Most high-end cameras process around 24 megapixels, but the human eye can get 52 megapixels on average and hundreds of megapixels if you take into account the whole field of vision. It's pretty ridiculous. What you see isn't just one image, it's dozens of images or more. You don't worry about overexposing, shutter speed, or aperture because your brain does that for you and filters out any errors in color or depth. In the end, the reason your photos don't look like what you see is because what you see isn't actually real. It's what your brain has created while sucking in all of that visual information and compiling it into three-dimensional, multi-million pixel worlds. Cameras do just one thing. They can't adjust nearly as fast as your eye or compile that information into a fluid image as easily. But a good photographer on a mountain at sunset sure can try. Of course, no one knows this stuff better than Canon, and with Canon PIXMA Pro Professional Inkjet printers, you can expect a level of quality and accuracy that keeps each print true to your unique vision. All backed by Canon's commitment to provide professionals with fast, high-quality service that you can depend on. What do you guys think of stuff like this? Have you ever worried about your eye and your camera not being the same? Let us know down in the comments. Make sure you subscribe for more DNews, and we'll see you next time.